See, it's fine, it's fine. Now that we're actually fighting the boss, we've gotten our groove on again. It's fine, because the Rotten's not very hard. He doesn't do a whole lot. We want to get away from him now. He doesn't do very much. He's basically shown off his full repertoire at this point. Oh dear. Yeah, that was going to be a problem because I ran out of stamina. Oh god, I shouldn't have done it! Okay, so we're up, back up by Sir Glowy Sword and the Statue Lady. Now, when we... First, let's kill these people hiding back here. Let's not keep digging off the wall. Now, when we unstatue the Statue Lady with a fragrant branch of yore, we are going to get ganked like we've never been ganked before. What does this say? Is there? I don't believe you. No. And what does this say? Oh god, I was tricked and duped. Well, whatever, fine. What does it say? Regret? Hell yeah. You got me there. Alright, so we're gonna... Oh, we're being ganked before we've unstatued her. I guess because of the explosion. This is just as well, because the lady we are about to unstatue is actually an NPC, not just some random dude who we beat up, like usual. And she can actually die because of the gank squad, which is not advised. It's kind of hard. She's got some health, so... But now we will unstatue her. And was that all of the gank squad? Looks like it. I remember there being more of the gank squad. Okay, we get the idea.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, yes, cough, cough.
Oh, a moment, please.
Shut up, Basilisk. I know you're behind the door.
I'm fine. I think.
Are you sure? Do you need a minute?
I'm fine. Really, I am. My name is Rosabeth. Thank you so much for rescuing me.
Shut up, Basilisk.
Oh, you're that traveler. I still haven't thanked you.
You just did?
I'm quite a hand at pyromancy. So perhaps you could consider this my thanks.
Oh, great.
I was attacked and turned to stone, I think. I owe you my life. If you had not come... I feel shameful wearing these rags. I hate to burden you further, as you've already saved my life. But just look at me. My clothes are in tatters. Do you have any clothing that you could spare? I'll take anything, whatever you don't need. I'm not particular when it comes to apparel. Anything at all will do. Just put it on the ground, and I'll change into it later.
So, we can give her whatever we like, and she will wear it. So we could give her something absolutely ridiculous, like the Smelter Demon armor, and she will wear it. But let's give her something reasonable. Wanderer coat. I shouldn't give her the plus two, but it doesn't really matter. That hat. It doesn't matter what we give her, just as long as it is something. Just like Wanderer stuff. Why not? It kind of, yes. And, she sells us pyromancies and pyromancy related things, but Again, that's not what we're doing.
I have my very own teacher. His name is Carillion of the Fold, a famed sorcerer in Melfia, our hometown. I was fascinated by sorcery. And so, well, he's so unique, you see. When he set out for Drang Lake, I couldn't let him go alone. But we were separated quite early on, I'm afraid. I'm rather unskilled, and the Lord probably ditched me. But, oddly, I'm a fast learner when it comes to pyromancy. What we're fascinated by, and we're skilled at, are not always the same thing. Oh, why can't I just focus on what I truly enjoy? Oh dear, I shouldn't be so choosy. It's hardly my place.
Okay. And so, because we've given her some stuff, she'll go back to Majula.
I'm very happy for this gift. After I change into this, I'm heading for Majula. I'm not sure where I might find the Lord. But perhaps Majula is my best chance.
Well, we're building quite a town over there. You can go and hang out with Blacksmith Dad. Various women of varying degrees of sanity, a talking cat, a pompous man. There's all sorts of people over there. Now I can finally kill this basilisk that's been taunting me behind this door all the conversation. Finally, it's dead. Now to loot the room. What does this say, actually? Right, and then hurrah for treasure. Are you a mimic? Nope. Can never be too sure. We've died enough this time. We've not died enough this run through. Estus Flask Shard. I'm not going all the way back to Majula just for that. I have plenty. A bonfire. Nothing else in the room? Nope. And various other rooms, I felt. Because. Okay. I will jump. Ugh. Because that annoyingly blocks the path. Hello, sir. And any hidden doors? Nope. Okay. Just check in. Oh, hello. You're a bit different. I do not remember you being. Oh, you got. I thought you had a little peg arm for a second. Large titanite. Oh, thank you. That's very generous of you. And stuff we don't particularly care about. Now to the other side. Do our due diligence. Loot the room thoroughly. Gank all these poor unsuspecting people. They're just trying to have a good time in their little hovel rooms. But then we come along. Be wary of head. Yes, there is a spike. And the final room. Which better have something in it. I swear to God there was something in here that was worth all this trouble, but apparently not. How'd you die? Did this guy kill you? Oh my goodness, you're absolutely rubbish. Oh my goodness. I could have sworn there was something. Whatever. Now, moving on. So we must begin our fairly long journey, actually, to get to the last of the... great souls. We have to go through a few areas to get there, and a few bosses in between. And, one annoying area with barely visible men. You might recall a similar area in Dark Souls 1 where the barely visible men in a forest ganked you. It's very much the same. In fact, almost exactly the same, except there's more mist, so it's harder to navigate. But first, we must go through these nerds who are throwing rocks at me, which is quite rude. But the game kind of expects us to come through this area a lot earlier, so we're somewhat over-leveled. Typically people, like, do something like the Rotten, then this area, then the Lost Sinner, then the Fire, the Old Iron Keep, something like that. And basically this is one of the first areas people generally go to, but we break from tradition and go do things the harder way and go to the harder areas first for no particular reason. And I'm being quite terrible again. Let me just use this life gem so I don't croak from the poison. Oh, hello! Well, alright. So I was rolling away, but apparently I missed someone behind me, which is, quite terrible. I didn't know he was there, and then I rolled straight back into him after being, well, generally wrecked by those four. Right as I was talking about how we were overleveled. Well, we'll get to kill the basilisk again. Creepy bastards. Alright. This time I'm not gonna die like that. This isn't gonna be like the last time I sat down to record. Oh no! That's gonna be the only death during the entire session I'm recording right now. Mark my words. And then it hard cuts to the very next death. Alright, but it's not gonna be the same death. Oh no. I'm not gonna get... Oh! Are you the fellow that came up behind me? Was it that guy throwing rocks? It was that guy, wasn't it? I don't remember killing someone up there. It was you, wasn't it, sir? It was you who snuck up behind me and I rolled backwards into. Alright, it's not gonna happen again. Oh, he didn't die. That's really inconvenient. Damn. He's got, like, literally one pixel of health and he didn't die. That is terrible. Probably shouldn't just be... just, like, YOLOing in, swinging both swords, in all honesty, but I like to live life on the edge. Yoink their stuff, and no other path, okay. Forgive me, everything looks a bit the same in the woods. And another bonfire. Probably in case you're a loser like me who dies to those guys. And now there are several ways we can go. That is the misty path I was talking about. Where does this one go? One of them leads very quickly into a dead end, but we will go that. You, I do not recall being over here. Have you always been over? No, surely not. No, these guys are new. They're wearing that fancy armor we picked up, some of that fancy falconer set. Well, that probably says that he did it. He was a very clever man jumping up onto the rock and leaving a message. Oh, the prediction. I tried to juke him, but it just didn't work. Ooh. Got him. Nope. Oh. You sneaky devil. Clever girl. Alright, now, what do you have, sir? Various goods. You have two Twinkling Titanite? He had two of something. I think it was the Twinkling Titanite. That's quite a haul. Not that we're actually using any weapons that are upgraded with Twinkling Titanite, but the Scimitar and the Falcion are somewhat being outscaled at this point. We might have to find new weapons. I'm concerned. You might ask yourself why I'm concerned, and that's because there used to be a Flexile sentry here, and now there isn't. Ah! Oh, I thought you were a Spectre! Oh my goodness, I thought you were just some dude in the area. Oh my goodness. You clevered. Oh my god. I got ganked before I even got into the forest of ganking. Seems I was right to be concerned. There used to be a Flexile sentry there, but now it's just that blood. I thought he was a fucking specter in another world that I could see. But no, he was there. He was quite physical. So this is the Shrine of Winter. This opens once we have the four great souls, or... I don't think I explained this. The other way you can open it is, if you have 1 million soul memory, which is just the total amount of souls we've collected over the entire time. I think we can look at our soul memory. Yeah, that... I'm pointing at my screen like you can see me, but that very top right number in that window is our soul memory, and that's the total number of souls we've collected over the entire run. And if you have 1 million of those, that also opens up the Shrine of Winter, which is faster, strictly speaking, than getting the four great souls. So if you're speedrunning the game, basically what people do is kill the Rotten four times, because he's very quick to get to, and you just use, like, a bunch of bonfire aesthetics to fight him over and over again, and you get a million souls. Also, soul memory is how it calculates PvP. I'm a bit concerned by that swirling mass. Hello? What are you? I do not recollect these creatures. Soul memory is also how it calculates PvP, by the way, because it used to do it like people between certain level ranges would get mashed with other people in certain level ranges, but then now it works off soul memory in basically the same way, right? It's in tiers. So this guy was not up here also, as you might have guessed by the fact I suddenly went quite quiet. So yeah, we've seen a couple of these guys. This is the first time we're actually gonna fight one, though. And basically... Oh, he's quite the burly man. That did not do very much damage. Ooh, don't do it. That, I believe, is the grab move. He has a grab where he, like, nibbles on your head, basically, and you don't want to get caught by it. Oh, my goodness. Oh, I am going to need to find some better weaponry at some point in the near future. We will actually be coming up to the NPC not too long from now that gives you the, boss soul weapons in this game. Well, we meet her, but then we have to go and, like, actually talk to her again in a different area, and she will do it. Oh, God, please, no. Okay, he leashes back here. This is taking some time to kill this man. Well, perhaps it's a woman. I don't know. I shouldn't... It's an ogre, though, by the way. This is Shrek. There are several Shreks. Like that one we saw way back at the beginning of the game in the river. There were also a couple more in Things Betwixt. That reminds me. Jeez, that was close. I have to go back to Things Betwixt because I have a few fragrant branches of yore, and stuff over there is different, of course. Oh my god, I'm terrible at this. Back up! Alright, cheesing him a little bit here. Ooh, but it's... I somewhat speculate that he was designed with me being a... This guy was placed with me, this intending me to be a bit stronger than I currently am. I'm a pretty high level, but I'm using kind of crappy gear, honestly. Like, because, like, this is still the scimitar I started the game with that I'm using right now. And I've had, of course, many opportunities to change my weapon, and just sort of have not done it. Alright, I fell down, which is fine. Oi! Oi, come back! Oh! He's like, alright. Get him? Alright. Do you drop anything? Cheap. There are a couple other guys. There are a few others of those guys in this game, and they all drop something, like, unique. That reminds me, there's, like, a hidden area right back where we started the game before we even spoke to the old ladies that we haven't been to yet. Okay, I do not recollect these creatures at all, but... He put bleed and petrification on me, so that's quite terrible. Red tier stone ring, when we're below... 25% life, it increases the damage we do. Pretty good weapon if you're an absolute hero and don't mind being one hit from death all the time. And we also can't go this way, but I'm coming this way basically to show you all paths that are currently blocked off. And it says, produce the symbol of the king, which we cannot do. Basically until we've been through the Shrine of Winter, because that's what we're working towards right now. We're working towards getting through the Shrine of Winter and getting to the castle behind there. Then we will get the symbol of the king, and we will be able to enter this door, but there's also an area back in the woods at the start of the game, or near the start of the game, where we fought the last giant that also is locked with the door that says the same thing. So once we've been through the Shrine of Winter, we'll be able to go through both of those. And, yeah. Basically, once we get through the Shrine of Winter, there's only a few areas left in the game. Discounting the DLC, because the DLC areas are all quite big. They all have three bosses in them, I think. Yes, I think one of them has four, actually. Either way, so this is the forest I was expecting to be ganked in, and now this is probably a guy I'm gonna be walking through the mist and come face to face with a Flexile sentry. So, there are lots of those, or there should be lots of those dudes that ganked me earlier in here, but they're basically impossible to see, because you can't lock onto them, of course, and they are much the same color as the damn mist. Also, there's lots of stuff in here, and I'm probably gonna miss some of it. But this is the important place. Now, you might look around here and say, why is this important place? The important place. There's an NPC here! Can you pick out the head? It's the one with the slightly reddish thing around it. That is typically what swords do, yes. It's not lying, by the way. His body is quite burly, though I can never quite remember where it actually is. So yes, interestingly enough, this head has items to sell us. I know, right? You can buy gold pine resins, lightning urns, various assorted goods, a claymore. I'm a fan of claymores, as you might remember from Dark Souls 1. Teaches us the decapitate gesture. Oh.
Perhaps it's for the best. We knew not what we fought. I was born in Feroz when I was born.
Sorry, I'm gonna have to cut you off there, man. I've apparently been invaded. Okay. I'm wary. Is it. Oh! Hello! Oh! Hello, sir. No. Oh! Well, alright. Great. Fantastic. There'll be no shields today. Great. Fantastic. There'll be no equipment today. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. So all my gear's broken, so I'm not doing like no damage now also, which is great. Actually, my swords aren't broken, surprisingly. Yes, sir, I understand. You have a very novel build. Thank you for sharing. Yes, quite. Very, Verily. Whatever, I'm gonna go talk back, go and talk to my head friend. You be that way. See if I care, and because you're being a nerd, am I also going to heal, even though we're technically PvPing? I'm grateful for these peaceful days. But such contentment lies only in the here and now. Why must life be? Oh, he's coming back. He's coming back. Hello. Okay. Yep. Right. Verily. Let's give him an emote, shall we? Righty ho. Yes. No. Yes. Okay. Quite. Are you done? We got anything novel we can do in here? We got prism stones, right? Let's throw a prism stone on the ground. Yes, of course. Whatever. Get out of here. Alright. Guess I'll go fix all my gear. Yes, very good. How rude of him. I was speaking to a head at the time. Well, I'll go back to Father Blacksmith. Get him to fix all my stuff since it's all now broken and rusty, as you might notice. Majula. So we will reconvene back in that area. Alright, so after spending a hilarious number of souls repairing all my gear, we're back. I also forgot to upgrade the Estus Flask with that shard. I know, I'm terrible. And now we are going to make our way through this area, trying to find all the hidden loots while also not getting ganked by invisible people. And I mean actual NPC invisible people, not just that dude as well. Oh! Oh my goodness, they're even harder to see. Ah! Nope! Ah! Damn, I tried to get my shield out, but... Alright, so... Remember how I said I was only gonna die once during this recording session? I'm currently 31 minutes into the recording session and I've died 3 times. One of them was invader related though, so I'm gonna count that one off, alright? But yes, that one was just like, I tried to equip the shield, pushed the button too many times, went back to swords, terrible, bad times. They're hilariously even harder to see in Scholar of the First Sin than they were in the original game. I don't know if you guys could see him at all, because I could just barely make him out. Is he gonna come back? No, okay. I was a little bit further up. Ah! Oh dear, I missed. Oh dear. Oh! Got him. Alright. Like, he is hilariously invisible. A proper sneaky predator, that one. Alright, I warn you, I am gonna miss some things in the mist. There's one thing I'm looking for in particular. There's this ramp along one of the walls that goes up to a chest. Not that chest. But I will open- Ow! Where are you? Aha! Ow. Yes, it's a pain because you can't lock on to them either. Can sort of see him, just sort of following his health bar. Where'd he go? God damn it, I lost him. This rascally rabbit! Where are you? There you are. So yeah, quite a common area to die in, particularly your first time through when you don't expect these guys. So this isn't the chest I was looking for, but there is another one in here. What does this do? Old Sun Ring? Old Sun Ring. Explodes damage. Oh, that's quite a hilarious item, actually. Once you take enough damage, you explode outward. It's quite interesting. That's a death drop, by the way. Fairly novel, but we won't be using it. Did I hear someone move? Oh, someone tried to shoot me with an arrow. This man. So yeah, you guys probably can't see him at all, honestly. Because I can barely see him, and I've got better quality than you're going to have. Ah, this is what I was looking for. I assume that is an actual person specter and not something planning to gank me. So along this very narrow ridge is this here chest, which is not a mimic. Generally, mimics in precarious places like chests in precarious places like this are not mimics. Ho ho ho, a clarity ring plus one. We of course have this, but now we have the plus one. Which is of course slightly better. I actually am going to double up. Oh! Hello? Stab him. Stabbed. Oh, didn't want to use the Estus on that, but whatever. Actually, no, because... Oh, I didn't even equip both of them. Because I was going to say my gear will break too fast. Scimitars and Falcions, quite fragile items. So this should be the way to actually leave this area. Be done with this godforsaken place. Yes, here we go. Ooh, we're finally three. I also apologize if that was a bit hard on the eyes. It was very white, I know. So now we are in the next area. I see a person that is very NPC looking. First we'll use this bonfire just in case I get ganked.